Simon then published a video about the recreation of the Eratosthenes experiment by Anthony Beer. Then called it, "Watch this flat earther get famous experiment totally wrong." But in reality, Anthony Beer didn't do that bad a job. He took two measurements from two locations, lying almost at the same longitude line. He did it at the same time, at the same day, be it not exactly at noon. He used a proper instrument and leveled it. Then he drew his results into AutoCAD, first with a flat earth, then with a globe earth. So far, so good. Simon then complains about it not being an exact replica of Eratosthenes, because it wasn't done at the summer solstice, and one of the locations wasn't at the Tropic of Cancer. Then he states that the locations Michigan and Florida, Bear didn't mention the precise locations, which is typical for a flat earther, aren't exactly at the same longitude line. After that, Dan complains about Bear measuring the distance to the sun, something Eratosthenes didn't do. Then Dan states that the rays to the sun are parallel, and on the flat earth model of Bear, they are not, and goes on asking for an explanation of the movement of the sun above the flat earth. But when Bear presents his drawing of the sun rays on a globe, and the calculation of a sun at a distance somewhere around 8,000 miles, then goes off on a tangent. He asks the question, which scenario would be the most likely, that of a close sun, or that of a sun far away? But in my opinion, he misses the point completely. How can Anthony Beer come up with a drawing of a globe model where the sun rays are not parallel? I'm a glober, and I couldn't believe that he could get accurate measurements and get this result just the same. So I started to recreate his drawing in NanoCAD, a drawing program similar to AutoCAD. When I calculated the angle in order to get the distance over the surface of 1150 miles, the distance Bear claims for Michigan, Florida, it began to dawn to me. The formula is quite simple. The angle is the distance divided by the circumference of the Earth, and the result times 360 degrees. So 1150 over 24,875 times 360 comes out to be 16.639 degrees. This 16.639 degrees was very close to the difference of 16 degrees between both angles Anthony Beer had mentioned.
And the top orange line is from Michigan to the sun, which is 3,154 miles. And that's on a 34 degree angle. And then the second line, orange line, is from Florida to the sun, which is 2,291 miles. And that's on a 50 degree angle.
34 and 50 degrees. With a difference of only 0.639 degrees, the sun rays in Beer's drawing would have to be almost parallel. And they weren't. When I finished my drawing, it looked quite different from that presented in Beer's video. Indeed, the sun rays met at an angle of 0.6366 degrees, and the sun stood at a distance of 63,963 miles, not 8,000 miles. So the measurements of Anthony Beer would have to be only 0.6 degrees off in order to have parallel sun rays. But how could he have gotten his drawing so terribly wrong? In the drawing of the flat earth, his angles are spot on, so the measured angles would have to be right. However, in the drawing of the globe earth, which I had to correct for perspective, how come that flat earthers haven't learned how to print screen, but always record their computer screen with their phone? He has the 15 degree angle jacked up to 57 degrees. I think that he either doesn't know how to rotate the line in AutoCAD to the proper angle, or he did it right and was so shocked by the fact that the lines were almost parallel and that the sun would be lying behind the observer that he just rotated the line to the sun a little bit further till he got a result that suited his narrative but much better. His drawing of the flat earth was correct, so I'll have to go for the second option. Anthony Beer just cheated, or should I say, he just lied through his teeth. He didn't debunk the globe at all. He provided evidence that the globe model could be a viable model. Let's wait for the multiple location measurements he announced. Then he will definitely debunk the flat earth model. I bet those measurements never will be published.